Okay, so continuing. So let's revive the keyboard slider we had here, and try to play these notes. For this, we use a message called note and hey did $1 sign, otherwise known as X. Okay, so we played a note. Okay, so there it goes. What this means, the help file says that it steals the note. So I have 10 instances of Polly, and note message automatically allocates the Polly that's not playing. So like this. Okay. But anyway, so listen to this. I literally made a very long sound. So listen what happens. When I play notes, it cuts off. So this is no good. So you go back to your poly sub. And let's make it a little bigger. And here we use something, whoops, called this poly. Okay, so this poly. Okay, is it gonna have a non-understandable help file? Poly voice allocated. Yeah, okay, that's okay. All right, so remember I left the little bang here. When the line ends, it sends a bang, right? So here, remember this? So this is the note pitch that's coming in from the key slider outside, right? From the top level. This, right? So this is coming in here through the note. And then first, it sends the note number to M2F. This is the MIDI to frequency converter. Now it's a frequency and plays a cycle. And then, well, set the cycle in here. And then send the bang to play, to go through the amplitude through line tilde, right? So I'm going to add one more thing here. It says before I even send in the note, one more bang. So these are still intact, but now I have one more bang over here, and I want to send a message to this poly. I don't know, it should be here. This is a crisscross situation. So here we need a message mute. So here is the extremely confusing part. So mute 0, 1, 0, 1. This means it's not muted because mute is 0. And this particular poly, which is poly sub 1, is busy, means 1. I am not muted and I am on. Not muted, I am on. So I'm going to send that to this poly object. Okay, so this means that when the note comes in, I free this poly, unmuted, and say I'm active to this poly, and then send the integer to be converted to a frequency, right? And then play the note. So unmuted, frequency goes in, and then play the note. So now here is when I'm done with this note, it sends a bang, right? So now I am going to mute it. So this time it's 1, 0, which means I am now muted and I am not active, which is 0. Okay, so this is a confusing part. There you go. Well, it's not confusing because I just said it. Anyway, so okay, so this is going to be my poly 70. Usually it sort of understands by itself. Sometimes you have to reload the object. I think now it's smart enough to know the new version of this poly implemented sound. So now let's Listen, it's supposed to work, it better work. Okay, so here, one. Simple, but demystifying the this polytilda and the mute messages.